Hello friends and welcome back to my kitchen. Today we are going to see how to make kandi podi. Kandi pappu in English means tuvar dal or tuvaram paruppu in Tamil. So let's start cooking. I have placed a pan over medium heat and I am adding a small cup of tuvar dal. Let's start roasting it over medium flame till the dal begins to change color. And once it starts to change color, reduce the flame completely and roast it till it becomes golden brown in color. The cup that you use to measure can be of any measurement. I've used a small cup, meaning a quarter cup of tuvar dal. You can also use a half cup measurement or a one cup measurement depending on the quantity that you want to make. Now the dal has become golden brown in color, so I'm going to transfer it to a clean bowl and keep it separately. To the same pan, I'm adding quarter cup of fried gram dal, which is nothing but chutney dal or pottu kadalai. And once again, I'm going to roast it till it changes color. Make sure that both the dals get roasted evenly. Roast the dal over medium-low flame so that they don't burn. Even if one or two dals change blackish in color, it will ruin the taste of the kandi podi completely. Instead of fried gram dal, you can also use regular chana dal, but we prefer pottu kadalai or this roasted gram dal. Now this chutney dal has also turned golden brown in color. So I'm going to transfer it to the same bowl to which I've transferred the tuvar dal and I'm going to let it cool. To the same pan, I'm adding 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds and I'm going to roast this also over medium-low flame till I get a nice aroma from it. Like all powders, kandi podi should also be made in small batches and consumed within 2 or 3 weeks before it begins to lose its flavor and aroma. The cumin seeds are nicely roasted, so I'm going to transfer this to the same bowl in which I've transferred the dals. To the same pan, I'm adding half a teaspoon of oil, followed by 6 to 7 whole dry red chilies and a sprig of curry leaves, and start roasting till the chilies change color. The amount of red chilies that you add to the kandi podi depends on your spice level. You can add more or less according to your choice. Once the chili start to change color, I'm going to transfer it to the same bowl in which I've transferred the dals and let it cool once again. To the same pan, I'm adding half a teaspoon oil again and I'm going to add 8 to 10 garlic pods. Saute it over low flame till the outer skin of the garlic becomes golden brown in color. The garlic should get half cooked and the skin should become golden in color like this. Switch off the stove and let it cool in the pan itself. The roasted dals that we have kept in the bowl have cooled completely, so I'm going to transfer it to a mixie jar now and I'm going to grind it to a coarse powder. To this mixie jar, I'm going to add the roasted garlic, quarter teaspoon of asafoetida or hing, salt to taste, and once again grind it to a coarse powder. This is how coarse the texture of the kandi podi should be. Now transfer this powder from the mixie jar to a bowl and let it cool completely. Break off if there are any lumps, and once it cools down, you can transfer it to an airtight jar. To 1 cup of cooked rice, add half a teaspoon of ghee, few tablespoons of this kandi podi, mix it well and have it with any dry sabzi. Versatile and easy kandi podi is ready. I hope you'll all give it a try and share your feedback with me. If you like this video, do not forget to like, comment and share it with your friends. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon to receive further notifications. Until I meet you all with the next recipe, happy cooking and happy eating!